Hello, my friends, it's Dani, and today I am showing you how to cook broccoli in the most delicious way. This is a sauteed broccoli recipe that cooks with garlic and olive oil. It is so tasty, so easy to make, and dare I say, it's borderline addictive. Now, because this recipe comes together so quickly, I like to have my ingredients prepped and ready to go before I get to the stove, which doesn't take long at all since we only need a few ingredients. So I have one head of broccoli that I've washed, and I'm gonna separate the florets from the stems. For this recipe, we're not gonna need the stems, but you don't have to toss them. You can save them and use them in very simple recipes like my broccoli stem soup, or you can give them a quick saute with a little garlic and olive oil, and then scramble them into your eggs or your omelets, or just put them on top of a salad as an easy way to get in some more greens and a little extra fiber. As for the florets, you just want them to be fairly equal in size so that they all cook at the same time. I like to cut the really big florets in half, working from the stem up, and then once I get to the actual crown, I just pull it apart. This way none of the little florets break or you don't get any crumbles from the broccoli. It's a really easy, clean, neat way to cut your broccoli. And one head of broccoli should get you about 4 cups of florets. Now, the next ingredient I need is some fresh garlic. Anywhere between 4 to 6 cloves, depending on how big your garlic cloves are or depending on how much you like garlic. We really like garlic here, so I usually go towards the higher end. Now, the easiest way to get your garlic out of the skins is just to lay it on your cutting board, put your knife right over the top and give a gentle, firm tap, and it splits the skins and then they peel right off. So once I've got them all peeled, I'm just gonna give them a rough chop and the garlic is ready to go. Other than my garlic and my broccoli, all I need for this recipe is some salt, pepper, extra virgin olive oil, and then a little bit of water as well. And if you like heat, some red pepper flakes would be a great addition, but since I like to make this for the family, I usually skip it. Now, to cook the broccoli, I've got a nice big nonstick skillet heating up over a medium heat. You don't want the heat to get too high because you run the risk of burning the garlic. So you just want something towards medium, medium low, depending on your stove. Now, once the pan has heated up, I'm gonna add my olive oil to the pan. I'm using 2 tablespoons of olive oil. It doesn't look like a lot for all of this broccoli, but it's really all you need. You just need enough to get the garlic cooking and just get the broccoli coated. If you wanted a little more liquid without the oil, you could even add a splash of water to the pan and that would get the job done. So once the oil is hot, I'm gonna add my garlic to the pan. I like to give the garlic a little pinch of salt, mix it around, and let it go for about 30 seconds. You're just looking for the garlic to do a little dance in the pan. You're gonna see it's gonna become fragrant very quickly. Again, we don't want it to brown. So once this is happening, I'm ready to add the broccoli. So in goes my broccoli along with a little bit more salt and some black pepper. Now from here, I just like to gently toss the broccoli with the oil and the garlic. You just want everything to get mixed together really well. And I'm just gonna let this go for about 2 minutes. And in that short period of time, you will notice that the broccoli goes from a dull green to a really bright, vibrant green. Once you have arrived, you are ready to add your water. So I've got 1/4 cup of water going into the pan, and then I'm just gonna pop the lid on. Now the broccoli is gonna steam for a little bit. I'm gonna set my timer anywhere between 3 and 5 minutes. If you like your broccoli really soft and really tender, go closer to 5 minutes. If you tend to like it a little more al dente with a little bite to it, you wanna come down to around the 3-minute mark. Now, if you enjoy really simple recipes like this one I'm sharing today, let me know by liking the video, and if you haven't already, subscribed to the channel, because your feedback really helps me get some clarity on what type of content is most helpful to you. So I do appreciate that. Now, you'll see when I remove the lid, the broccoli is this beautiful, bright, vibrant green, and it is fork tender, just like this. That's how you know it's pretty much ready to go. I just like to let it go another 30 to 45 seconds at this point to let any leftover water that's in the pan evaporate out. From here, you are ready to serve and enjoy your broccoli. And if you're cooking it up on the weekend doing meal prep, which is something I often do, then once it cools, just transfer it into an airtight container and it will last in your fridge happily for up to 5 days. I cannot wait for you to give this recipe a try. I will see you all back here next time with some more clean and deliciousness. Cheers!